ticket, never giving profit on the cost of living. Children starving every day. We gotta get on the right track, and there'll be no turning back. Gotta find a brand new way. I'm giving my love to you. My love to you.
Thank you. loud.
It is completely not political. Thank the great wave for that. And it is coming through the Nordic Ocean and the dream time of music. We are the world government of the future. We are listening to and understanding the core information from deep space.
We are the possessors of deep hearts. Deep hearts.
And we, all we just want to do is sing!
Because far away across deep space there is another world which we can only dream of. In far distant space, it's almost invisible. In fact, it's invisible to scientists. But we who have the vision and can sing the tune, we can hear the music coming from the trees. We can hear the music of the sea and the ocean and of the great wave. Take us deep. Take us deep, or we will find in you this planet gone.
Arrived at the gig in time-honored Gong fashion about 10 minutes before we were due to go on, and we had all the equipment. The rest of the band were a little, shall we say, edgy. You know how it is. Anyway, we did the gig. It was pretty hot, so we were free to indulge ourselves just a little, you know. Pip was right there at the bar, sitting next to, it was a guy called Neil, who was one of our roadies. Pip has been drinking steadily, probably for 2-3 hours at the bar, and all of a sudden, barman decides that Pip has had enough. There was a pyramid of champagne glasses behind the bar. It's a terrible story, this. It gets worse, believe me. Anyway, he's picked up the shot glass and just gone, and it's gone straight into this pyramid of champagne glasses, which has gone all over the place. There's glass everywhere. And he has ducked under the bar. Neil is sitting next to him. What's going on? You know, I'm on the other side of the room, but I see six bouncers who saw Pip very clearly do this, marching very purposefully towards him. So I thought the best thing we could do would be to sort of try and get between the bouncers and him and shepherd him gently out towards the lift, you know. Get him back to his room, everything would be okay. Unfortunately, he mistook my intentions. He thought I was coming to get him. So he's taken a lunging, mad sort of bulldog dive at me, and he's gone crash into this 20-foot palm tree, which is in the bar, which has gone scab-locked. Earth, bits of dust, leaves, trees, everywhere, you know. It's just a total wreck. The receptionist looked very impressed, you know. So he paid the bill like the gentleman he is. He paid the bill, got on the bus and fell asleep. Like I say, it could only happen to Pip, and it happened almost every day. God bless.
Actually dressed as a pixie, and Richard Branson came bouncing in dressed as Father Christmas, and he said, I'm going to go and give out some presents to the band that are working here. And Richard would pull out the presents and I'd hand them out to them all. And I thought nothing more of it, and then, except that about a month later I split up with this girlfriend. She rang me out of the blue about March, I think, of 73, and said, look, I'm with this band, and they've got a Leo guitarist, and there's this Scorpio drummer and an Aquarius saxophone player and an Aquarius keyboard player, and they need a bass player, and if they had a Taurus, they'd have the four fixed signs of the zodiac, you know, fire, earth, air and water, and you're a Taurus and you're a bass player, so you must come immediately. And I said, well, I mean, they don't know what I play like, they never heard me, they know nothing about me. She said, no, you must come now, you're just perfect, you absolutely must go immediately. And actually I insisted, and David and Jilly were taking a break, a sabbatical, but they're coming through London, so I arranged that David would come and watch me jamming in a nightclub in the King's Road called the Pheasantry. Even before he'd heard me play, he just said, no, you're perfect, you must go immediately, just go, mate, you know. And I did, so I got my bass in one hand and a plastic carrier bag with a change of underwear, I think. Ended up at Sens station, and there was Venix Deluxe, Francis Linon, the switch doctor, and he'd come down to pick me up and drove me off in the van to this fabulous place, the Pavillon du Hay. And there in this wooden hunting lodge, about 25 hippies from all over the world. I mean, you know, in this mad sort of collection of French and Australian and English and Americans and Germans, and me, a Fijian. So I kind of contributed to the multinational thing. And the mad thing, of course, is that Maggie, the girlfriend, was absolutely right. Lovely things at the core of the Gong philosophy that I think should be used as a you know, some kind of therapy for anybody who goes into show business in general, but especially music. It's a very clever twist in a way of saying it, the idea that the musicians on stage are strings of a greater instrument played by the octave doctor.
I'm sure as the most observant of you will have noticed on the programme, it mysteriously says that we're starting at 8:50 and that we're finishing at 8:25. So what we're doing at the moment is playing 25 minutes of music backwards for you. We had a minus 25 minute set list.
Later growing up in years, we're listening to a David Allen scene. And I actually met him and Gilly and Harry at a festival down in the south of Australia, near Melbourne. And I noticed standing beside me on the stage was none other than David Allen himself. In one hand he had a Chinese drum, and in the other hand he had some false teeth. He had some plastic clacker false teeth, which he was clacking into the microphone, which was fairly typical. Lovely man. A bunch of us from that band stayed together, and within a not very long time we were called Kangaroo Moon, and we had our own thing going. Basically, Kangaroo Moon came to this end of the world, and it was very much with a leg up from David and our association with David, which then brought the whole Gong family to us and brought us to them. And so we sort of oozed into the world of Gong.